feel so cheesy wearing like this hat and the shirt. I feel like I'm making some commitment day video, but I wanted to be super spirited. Hey everybody, it is Paris. Today I'm doing a video that I'm so excited about and has been super, super requested pretty much since I started school here. If you guys could not already tell, I'm a freshman here at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Go Badgers! I do a lot of college vlogs. I do college day in the life, college week in the life, just kind of all about my life as a college student. I get so many questions and comments and DMs every single day all about UW. And obviously, I'm happy to answer questions and help out whenever I can. Like, I love that you guys think that I'm a reputable source and you enjoy watching my videos. I try to answer most of my DMs, but I get a lot of the same questions. And so I thought that I would just make one big video, everything you need to know about UW-Madison. And hopefully I will answer everyone's questions. If you're a prospective student, you're interested in UW, you want to apply, or if you're coming here next fall, you're already committed, which is so exciting. So I'm going to be talking about like dorms, which dorms you might want to live in, how I found my roommate, the food on campus, also just some general like pros and cons about the school. I've only done like 1.5 semesters here, so I don't know everything about the school, but because I'm decently through my freshman year, I feel like I know enough to advise other incoming freshmen. So the first big thing about UW that I'm going to be talking about is the dorms, because that is probably the most frequently asked question that I get. Ask me where I live, like where I recommend people to live, which makes sense because that is like a pretty important part about the freshman experience. There are two general areas of dorms here at Madison. There is the southeast dorms and the lakeshore dorms. I live on the southeast. If you guys are like familiar with campus, you can probably tell where I live just based on like my dorm and like what I show in my videos. So the first main dorm in the southeast is Witte. Witte is one of the two biggest dorms on campus. It is currently under construction, which is a fat bummer, but that means that next year when you lucky bastards get to come here, it's gonna be all done and brand new and really nice. That does mean that it's gonna be really hard to get into, I'm sure, because it's like the prime location and it's gonna be brand new and super, super nice. So obviously I would tell kids to pick Witte, but you're not gonna be guaranteed it at all. The second biggest dorm on campus is Celery. It's like a block, I guess, across the street from Witte, if that makes any sense. The dining hall is right between it. Celery is up next for construction, so it will be brand new in a couple of years, but as of now, it's still really old and really ratchet and the bathrooms are like bleh. But it is a good location, still a lot of fun, all that good stuff. There is also OG. OG has some good things about it. OG has a gym inside, so that's where we all have to go for the gym because the student gym has been under construction right now, just like everything on campus. OG has brand new rooms. I mean, not like brand new, obviously, but they were just built a few years ago, so they're super nice. They have nice high ceilings and nice walls. They don't have this like grody brick like we have. It is a little smaller and quieter than the other southeast dorms, so some people enjoy that, but some people don't enjoy that. It is right behind the dining hall, so it's same thing and a great spot. Next southeast dorm is Smith. Smith is pretty big. Smith is nice. The rooms are super, super nice. They have really tall ceilings. They're really nice and new. However, Smith is a little bit further away compared to the other southeast dorms. Like, it's out. But anyway, so Smith is obviously still in the southeast. It's still pretty close to a lot of things, but it is definitely a little further away than Witte and Celery and OG are, so you might just want to keep that in mind, but the rooms are super nice. And the final southeast dorm is Chadbourne, also known as Chad. Chad is like kitty corner from the business school. That's the best way I would put it. And it's down the street from Bascom Hill. So it's again a little bit further away than Witte and Celery and like the dining hall is, but it is still in the southeast. It's really close to classes. So the pros of the southeast dorms. The biggest pro is it is close to everything. You're close to State Street, you're close to Langdon, which is where all the sororities and frats are. You're close to the Memorial Union, you're close to the UW bookstore. You're right by the Kohl Center, which is where they play all the Wisconsin basketball and hockey games. And you're pretty close to a lot of classes. The southeast has right next to it East Campus Mall, which is a big just like building complex, I guess. And East Campus Mall has so much stuff in it. It has food places, it has the grocery store, it has the university health offices, which for me personally, I'm someone that's always sick. So I really, UHS has been a place for me. They also have a cycling place and a hot yoga place. There's also a post office right nearby, kind of random, but I use that because I use Poshmark so much. They're really big dorms, they're lots of fun, they're super, super social, which is what I like about it. It's always just a fun time. Some people might think that's a con. For me, it's a pro, but I do have friends who live in other dorms who don't like that it's quiet and like not as social there. So here are the cons of the southeast dorms. Again, this is literally all my opinion, so take with it what you will. The dorms are loud. Like I said, they're really social, they're really fun. There's people yelling in the hallways until like 3 or 4 a.m. sometimes. People are blasting music. At my school and a lot of other colleges, everyone goes out on Thursday nights as well, and like I have class on Friday. A lot of other people have class on Friday, so like I'm trying to go to bed somewhat early, but you know, people are just loud and screaming and yelling, blasting music in the hallways until really late at night, which is sometimes annoying. Along with that whole culture of the Southeast dorms. It smells like weed a lot. There's gonna be beer cans lots of places. You're gonna see puke in the bathrooms. A couple weeks ago, my dorm kid got arrested because he was peeing in the hallway, and then he assaulted a police officer, and then it was just kind of like a whole thing. That just kind of comes with the party school culture. And the final con of the Southeast dorms is the construction. It is so irritating, especially like me. I like to sleep in, and I don't usually always get to sleep in because the construction starts at like 7 a.m. every morning, and it's just... And the next area of dorms on campus is Lakeshore. The first Lakeshore dorm that comes to mind is Elizabeth Waters. Waters is probably the closest Lakeshore dorm. It's right down the street from Bascom Hall. They have their own dining hall inside. It is small, but that definitely is nice to not have to like go outside to get food. There's also DeJope. DeJope is a brand new dorm. It's huge, but it is pretty far away on campus. So I have friends that live there and they're like, yeah, the rooms are nice, but you're really far from everything. DeJope also has a dining hall, so that is a plus. There is also Cronsage, Phillips, there's Leopold, there's, I don't even know. I really don't know that much about Lakeshore. Lakeshore dorms, UW-Madison. There is Bradley, there's Adams Hall, Schlichter is a Lakeshore one, Sullivan, never even heard of that one, Tripp, also never heard of that one. The pros of living at Lakeshore. They are quieter and they're more private and more scenic. They're on the lake. Again, for me personally, that would be a con just because I'm like pretty social and I like having people around. But for a lot of people I know, they want a quiet space to come home to. They don't want to have kids screaming in the hallway at 3 a.m., which I can respect. You're close to the Natatorium, which is a really big athletic complex on campus. So there's a gym there, there's a pool there, there's tennis courts, all kinds of good active stuff that you guys might want to utilize. They're close to the soccer and the softball fields, if that means anything. They're close to Picnic Point, which is a really cool like scenic point on the lake. They're close to the hospital, which hopefully, fingers crossed, you guys don't ever have to go there, but in case you do, but say if you guys have an appointment there. The cons of Lakeshore, number one and the biggest, is it is far away. They're very far from most of campus. Again, they are close to some things, but like in general, the things that most freshmen are gonna want to use, it's really far from. You have to Uber, you gotta spend money, but some people might not care. The fact that they're a lot quieter and smaller might be a con for some people. Some people might think that's a pro. And beyond the campus like dining facilities, you have a lot less outside eating options, because obviously the campus dining halls have hours, versus at the Southeast, you're close to State Street. There's a ton of food places nearby. If you're on Lakeshore, you'd have to Uber there or walk like 30 minutes, and neither of those things are ideal. One thing that is interesting about UW-Madison is you don't have to live at the dorm your first year. You can live in an apartment if you would like. So there's Lucky Apartments. I know a lot of people live at Statesider. So there are alternative options if the dorm life is not for you. But I do know people who have that and they don't love it just because it's a lot harder to meet people. But you get obviously all the benefits of having your own place. I get a ton of questions about like finding a roommate and how I found my roommate. I found my roommate on the UW-Madison like class of 2022 Facebook page. I posted about myself. I just put some pictures of myself and like talked about myself. And yeah, I saw my roommate. I thought she looked cute. I was like, oh, she sounds similar to me. Slid in the DMs. A year and a half later, here we are. I've had great luck with my roommate, like honestly, like zero complaints. She's super great. I love her. I never really show my videos, which you guys sometimes think is weird, but I'm just, that's kind of like weird to me. Like, so that's kind of why, but I do like her. Like, we're super close. I just feel really lucky because I know a lot of friends that have roommate issues. But my best advice if you don't already have a roommate is just approach girls, message girls who seem similar to you. You don't have to be best friends with your roommate. Like, you're gonna meet other girls so many other places. So don't stress about it too much. Some girls that I know who are like seniors now, they were like, oh my God, I'm like freaking out about finding a roommate. And I'm like, it's not that serious. And other options to finding your roommates are rooming with someone you know or doing a random, and that's pretty much the only three ways of finding your roommate. So the next part about UW-Madison I'm going to be talking about is the food and the dining options, because obviously like eating and food options on campus is a super important consideration of going to a school. If you guys didn't already know, I'm gluten-free, so I get a ton of messages from other kids who are gluten-free or vegan or have allergies or whatever other kind of food limitations you may have, and they're like, you know, is the food there good? Do you have enough things to eat? Like, what do you recommend I eat at campus? Even if I wasn't gluten-free and dairy-free, I still like to eat pretty healthy and pretty clean, which is not always the easiest thing to do in college. If you end up living in the Southeast dorm like me, you will have Gordon's Dining Hall. It is a super big dining hall. It's pretty new. They just rebuilt it again a couple years ago. And they do have a lot of options there. I get a sandwich almost every single day because they have gluten-free bread, which is really, really nice. I get stir fry because that's a rice base. I get a rice bowl from the Mexican place. I'll get sushi. Sometimes I'll get like a chicken sandwich or a burger and just not eat the bun if I'm really feeling that. They also have a big breakfast bar with like omelets and stuff. They have gluten-free muffins and brownies and whatever. Honestly, can't really complain too much about Gordon's. They have a ton of options. There's also obviously the dining halls at Lakeshore. I've heard that they have really good options. Never eaten there myself. My personal favorite place to eat on campus with your housing money, with your meal plan, whatever, is the Memorial Union. They have the best food options by far. I just ate there today. I eat there all the time. They have a make your own pizza place, which is really awesome because it has gluten-free crust, which is key for me. They also have a restaurant called Rathskeller where they have like chicken tenders and fries and burgers. The sandwiches and burgers there, they have gluten-free bun options, which we love to see. They also have some really good looking breakfast food. I've never eaten it myself, but they have it. They have a make your own sandwich and salad place called Cart. They also have an ice cream place on there, and they have a Pete's coffee place. Also things on campus called Badger Markets, and they're also kind of similar to convenience store. It's just little on-the-go things, and they have those in a lot of buildings on campus. You can also get food at Union South. Personally, it's not my favorite. They have a Badger Market there. They have like a stir fry place, a pizza place. I don't really love the food there, but that's just my opinion. Some people really like it. And the final area for finding food on campus is State Street. State Street is obviously the hub for like the best foods to eat on campus. You have to spend your own money, but sometimes it's worth it to eat like a real meal. I'm just gonna read this off my list because I don't want to like forget anything. It's on State Street. You can find Noodles and Company, Chipotle, Qdoba, Starbucks, Taco Bell, Salads Up, Fruitables, which is like an acai smoothie bowl plate. They have Forage Kitchen, which is my favorite food place on campus. So freaking bomb. If you guys are into like health eating, you'll love that. There's also sushi places. There's a Jimmy John's. There's Short Stack Eatery and the Bassett Street Brunch Club, which are two bomb breakfast places. And there's a few Ian's Pizzas on campus. Ian's is a cornerstone of UW-Madison. They have the famous mac and cheese pizza. There's obviously a ton more restaurants and food places to eat on State Street. Those are just like the main ones that I think of. There's also a Wingstop and a McDonald's, but those are further away, so you either have to like Uber there or get them delivered. So hopefully that covered a lot of things about the food on campus, the places that I like to eat, and the options that you have. There are a lot of good food options on campus, I will say that. But to end off this video, I'm just going to be talking about the overall pros and cons of the school. Again, in my opinion, it is some things to keep in mind if you guys are considering coming here. Start with the pros. I love the campus. There's so many beautiful spots here. I just love the vibe overall of being at a big school like this. There's a lot of really cool historical buildings. There's a lot of really beautiful brand new buildings. There's a lot to do on campus. I love that it's a big sports school. It's a Big Ten college. It's a huge university. It may not be the best football team. I've had a disappointing season, but game days were still lit. The stadium was still filled. We also had pretty big basketball, which again ended in a little bit disappointing way, but the games were still really fun. We also have big hockey. Women's hockey just won the national championship. That's super cool. A lot of our runners are really good, so I just love all the sports on campus. I love that it's like a really big deal, really hyped up. And we have multiple sports that are big too, which I really like. It like a lot of schools are either a football school or they're a basketball school, but we have a lot of different sports. So I know I've talked about everything about the school besides school, but Madison is just a really great school academically. I feel really lucky to be able to go here. Whenever I'm traveling, I'm out of state, I love wearing my WSCO stuff, and people are always like, oh, do you go there? That's a really good school. Like, and I, you know, I have a lot of pride going here. It's really well known in the fields that I want to study and everything, so that was definitely a huge part in me coming here. I love showing people the graph from Barstool Sports. If you guys saw, like, back in the summer, where it was, like, the partying versus academics graph of, like, colleges, and Madison was, like, the highest in both. I was, like, on Wisconsin, baby. That's what we love to see. And the final thing about UW that made me want to come here is that it's close to home. I grew up pretty near campus. I am from Wisconsin. Obviously, that's like not super relevant for people who aren't from here, but that was a consideration. I don't love that I see people from high school everywhere. That's actually probably like one of my least favorite things about going here. It's nice being close to my family, being able to go home if I need. All right, battery died, had to do another switcheroo, but we're almost done. So my personal cons of UW, besides seeing people from high school everywhere, campus is really, really big, which is cool because there's a lot of stuff here, there's a lot of stuff going on, but it is annoying. Some of my classes are a 30-minute walk away, and then when it's cold out, you don't want to walk places, so you want to take the bus, but the buses can take forever, or you have to Uber places at night. It is annoying sometimes having such a big campus for those reasons. Like, I have friends that go to smaller colleges, and they say that they have, like, two buildings that are right next to each other, and that's where all their classes are, and they just switch back and forth every day, and I'm like, literally can't relate. I have to go all over this enormous campus. Another con that I sometimes find going to school here at UW, and because the school is really, really big, a lot of my classes are really big. I have some lectures with 300 plus people in it. It's been kind of difficult to adjust that whole like learning style and just kind of being talked at for an hour and not really getting to like interact with the professors and the teachers and everything like you're used to in high school. Not all your classes are going to be big. We have small discussions, and like your classes get smaller as they're like more specific. It's another consideration of coming here or just coming to a big college in general, because if you're at a smaller school, you will have smaller class sizes and you get to work more like one-on-one with the teachers and everything, which is definitely helpful. It's definitely hard to kind of be in class and not feel like you're absorbing anything because you're just being talked at and just writing notes the whole time. Now back to our regular scheduled programming. And the final biggest key con of University of Wisconsin-Madison is the weather. The weather is the absolute worst. Like, sometimes I'll be walking to class and it's so windy and cold out and I want to transfer right then and there. If you guys know, a couple months ago we had the polar vortex. It was negative 60 and they canceled classes for like a day for the first time in 7 years. They literally do not cancel classes for crap. It was negative 60 and they barely called off classes for like 12 hours. When I see kids at like Alabama or Georgia or Auburn and they get off school when it's like 40 degrees and flurrying, that makes my blood boil. Like, I don't know, as a Midwestern kid where I never had snow days and I have to go to school in the frigid cold, like the literal frigid cold, like it was colder than Antarctica that week. That was a little dramatic, but the point is the weather here
sucks.
It is absolutely terrible, and don't expect any snow days because you're not gonna get any. This video is super long. I've been filming for like 40 minutes. Hopefully I can edit this down, but I really wanted to get an in-depth discussion, everything you need to know about UW-Madison, because I get so many questions about campus every single day and I want to be helpful and I want to guide you all little baby badgers on your journey through campus. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and for those of you who've been asking questions, I really hope that this helped you. If you guys are coming to Wisconsin next year, comment down below because I freaking love to see it. It means so much to me when you guys tell me that my videos helped you make your decision or they inspired you to come here. There's only one thing left to say in this video, and that is on Wisconsin.